Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Several days ago, we turned down a 130W charger from Dell, and today we found out his brother, the 90W charger from Dell. Let's see what's inside this charger. The packaging is big, and we can see the charger, brand logo, and power. And here is how you use it. And here is the specification of this charger, and the certification marks are at the bottom.The packaging contains the charger, cable, and manual. This charger is wrapped with protective plastic film. The shell adopts a flame-retardant PC. The matte surface can prevent fingerprints and scratches. Dell logo is at the top. The input adopts three-prong interface, and the output comes with a USB-C cable as well as a USB-A port. But the USB-A can only support 10 watts.Here is the specification of the charger. Total output power is 100 watts. USB-C port supports 20 volts, 4.5 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 5 volts, 3 amp. Maximum output is 90 watts. USB-A supports 5 volts, 2 amp, 10 watts. It also supports wide range input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 hertz. The rated current is 1.7 amp.Here are various product certification marks from different countries or regions. As for the charger size, the length is about 130mm, the width is about 66mm, and thickness is about 22mm. The weight is about 356g, and it's about 444g with the cable. The length of the cable is about 1.8 meters. After using ChargerLab Power ZKT002 to test it, we found this cable does not have a eMarker chip,because the integrated USB-C cable can be without that chip. The indicator light will light up after plug it in. The KT002 shows the USB-C can support Apple 2.4a, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, and PD3 protocol. And it also has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 4.5A. The USB-A can only support Apple 2.4a, Samsung 5V 2A, and DCP protocol.Next, let's see the compatibility of this charger. For MacBook Pro 16-inch, the power is about 63 watts. For MacBook Air M1, the power is about 46.4 watts. For iPad Air 4, the power is about 27 watts. For Huawei Mate 40 Pro, the power is about 12 watts. For Mi 10 Pro, the power is about 16 watts. For Samsung S20 Ultra, the power is about 14 watts. So, that will be the brief introduction of this charger.Then let's continue to tear it down. So we can see the entire module has been wrapped by copper heat sink.And the plastic plate below is used for insulation and isolation. Remove the heat sink, and there's a lot of thermal adhesives between the components, then continue to clean it up. ChargerLab found its switching power supply adopts the architecture of PFC boost and QR flyback topology. The secondary circuit is controlled by the protocol chip. The front of the PCB will be some plug-in components such as capacitor,inductor, transformers, and two large heat sinks. The back is the control circuit. As for those two heat sinks, the big one can dissipate heat of components of primary circuit, and the small one can assist to rectify bridge to dissipate heat. The ground wire crosses the primary and secondary circuits. The input side has fuse, common mode trokes, film capacitors, etc. The fuse is 3.15 amp, 250 volts.This is a primary filter capacitor which comes from Luminous Town, 420 volts, 82 microfarad. Here is the rectifier bridge, 4 amp, 800 volts. PFC boost inductor is next to it, which is controlled by the master control chip on the back. The master control chip comes from Owen Semiconductor NCP1937C4. It's integrated PFC controller and quasi-resonant flyback controller.Two Navitas GaN MOSFETs are used as the MOSFET of PFC boost and switching power supply, respectively, model is MV6117. It adopts an integrated driver and complex control circuit in a 5x6mm QFM package. With standard voltage 650 volts, resistance is 120 milliohm. Here is an ultra-fast recovery diode used for rectification after PFC boost. Here is the main transformer of the switching power supply. Two optocouplers in here, and this capacitor is 35 volts 100 microfarad. The synchronous rectification and output filtering circuit are on the right. It consists of two capacitors and one inductor. A small PCB is on the left, equipped with step-down circuit of USB-A. Turning back, two Murata SMDY capacitors are between primary and secondary circuits. The chip is the MPS synchronous rectifier controller, which is very common in GaN chargers. The maximum operating frequency can reach 600 kHz. Here is the Alpha and Omega synchronous rectification MOSFET, with standard voltage is 100 volts. The parallel diode on the left is used to improve the light load efficiency. The Alpha and Omega output V-bus switch MOSFET is in the lower right corner. There are two particle chips marked with DPD021P. Here is a 5-amp fuse at the output used for overcurrent protection. And we can also see the built-in cable has only 3 corners inside. Continue to remove the small PCB of USB-A. It has 2 layers. This is an alloy inductor and the step-down circuit is below. A filter inductor and a V-bus switch MOSFET are next to the USB-A. Well, that will be all for the teardown of this charger. The USB-A port is different from other chargers, but the charging protocol is limited to PD. If your devices can support PD, the maximum power will be 10 watts. All the components come from the top brand, and the large heatsink and thermal adhesives enhance the internal stability and thermal conductivity. Okay, that's all for today's teardown, hope you'll like it. You can leave your comments below and we will try to reply to them. And don't forget to subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!